Yo, yo. What's going on, everyone? Today I just want to show you guys all the DLC armor and what they do. I guess we'll start off with the one I'm wearing. So I got the Catan Imperial set, which is all the armors I'm showing are the heavy ones. This one does all carry capacity plus 21. This one is not DLC, I believe, but I did loot it from someone's base, so I figured I might as well add it. This is also carry capacity. It's not too bad, but the Catan is way better. You got the Hyperion, which is alright looking. That's the look for the Hyperion. Kinda bulky. This one does follower damage and concussive damage. This is not DLC either. Well, let's move on to the DLC ones. We got the Poyten. Wore this in two videos ago. Or the purge video, I should say. This one does follower damage and concussive damage all the way down, and then it gives, what is that, 50% damage increase and 20% from the authority. It's not too bad looking either. It does go good with the mace. Obviously, you guys seen the redeemed. I've also been building, so I got structural integrity instead of beast of burden this time. Sumerian. So this is the barbarian. Kinda has the same look for the Voidforge dragon armor. Does health all the way down, then you got stamina as well for the last two. Bonus stamina. So I'm at 155, and then my health is obviously for. Or I mean 504. Now this one, I'm pretty sure you guys seen if you watch my SIPTA videos. Definitely like the looks of this one. But this one does stamina. Only a stamina bonus. So it's not too bad either. Then we got the Nemedian. This one kind of looks weird. Does plus 28 health for every piece, which puts me at 560. But yeah, it just looks weird. Not sure if I like that helmet look. And like I said, if you guys watched my SIFTA videos, I'm sure you've seen this vid this one. All stamina for the Slate Forged. Which is 176, but definitely the best look. Trying to get some more pieces of the Sobek. Doesn't look too bad. Oops. Trying to see if there's anything else. Oh yeah, the ones that are outside have the Guardian and the Pictish. I'll show you guys those real quick. This is definitely my favorite armor. I like the katana the best. Let me show you the Pictish. This is what I've been working on. Upgrading my house even further. So now my house goes from here all the way down to here. A little crazy. So Decus the Sharp, he is wearing the Pictish armor. All strength damage. So if you guys have any fighters, I highly recommend putting this on them. Just has the best strength bonus. I mean, look at that. He's already got 42 plus 10. The 10 is from Might of Giants, but 42 base strength damage. So I think he got like 27 or 30 from leveling up. Of course, it's getting dark, so it's hard to see. But this is the Guardian set. Also, all strength damage. I like it. For the females. Wait, there's a sandstorm coming. It's nighttime. Well, that's a little weird. I didn't think the sandstorm came at nighttime. Guess I'll give you guys a quick show. I'm in the best spot because I don't even get hit by it. It just goes straight over the bridge. Or it does look like it's coming right at me, doesn't it? Just curves. Well, if only you could fight this thing. If it was a boss monster in the game, I feel like that'd be so much better. Instead of just a storm that rolls through and, you know, wear a mask and do a journey step. Well, see you later, Sandstorm. And then for the Rangers, guess I'll go back here. I might make it easier. Lian's also wearing Voidforge, but he has the illusion set on. It was one of the free battle passes a while ago. So yeah, probably like a month ago. So this is Tyranian. Felix sets all agility, because of course archers need agility. But for the looks of that, that one's pretty good. If only it wasn't agility. And then you got the Dark Templar. All agility as well. Like I said, that one's pretty good as well. But females get the Dark Templar. Males get the Tyranian. Now there's so many more, like the late and medium. It's such a pain building those ones. Maybe one day I'll make them. Just to have them, I guess, but yeah, there's no really need. And there's also the assassin set, which I have not made yet either. And then Bear Shaman. Pretty sure that this is a carry capacity. Trying to see what else there is. Oh, the King's Guard helmet, which is only one piece. But that's if you get the Conan movie DLC. Median Pictish. And also, these are the from the movie as well. The Ravenger helmet and the Reaver helmet. This one you could probably make with the Setsite illusion set. I mean, it looks exactly the same. And then, yeah, the Setsite color helmet. Basically the same thing. But it's only one piece. Steppa's helmet. The boss that they defeat in the movie. Guess you can get that helmet as well. Oh yeah, I forgot about the Yamatai one. Now this one, I would think it would have higher defense because it's heavy, but it does not have that good of defense. This one's all health bonuses. And obviously I dyed it just to make it look brighter. I believe, I don't think I can, yeah, I can't take it. I guess I could take it off and show you. So I went with dark blue. I think this is the silver blue. 79. So definitely not the best. This is my little bar station. Still gotta build more stuff up here, but that's soon to come. And then I also added all this stuff up here. I wonder if I can actually make it up. All the statues from the movies. I think one of these actually, yeah, this one looks like Arnold. Same, it's just you got gold, stone, and dark stone. Then you got Sabotai. Perfectly at the den. And Valeria, she's watching out for over here. Oh yeah, I forgot I put this up here. She said no one comes back here for the perch. This makes it easier. Excuse me. Easier. Like anything. Any kind of locations. I try to put them where they are. Like this one is. Sepmeru. So I put it over there just to make it look. Oh, I guess I remember where it's at. This one. I think that was the drugs. Yeah. And then this one. That's what I call the cave. But it's really. This place, Descent of Dagon. And then you got the two people, two archers at the volcano. This is the Quillian statues. I was hoping to fit these in my house, but they were way too big. So then I just added them up here. I'm sure you guys seen the statue in everyone else's video. This is all they ever use, just this Argosian statue. Now this one, I can't show you the front, but yeah, you get the picture. And the Argosian horse statue. And the trident and the Kraken. Kraken. If only you could drink from this water. This is the project I'm working on. Oops. There's nothing underneath there, so. Expanding my house all the way down. It's a little bit of a weird build. I figured I'd just do pillars and then ceiling pieces for the middle all the way down because the land goes up. Well, I guess it'd be right there is the highest point. Then it goes down one. And down another, and down another, and down another, and down another. There might be one more level. Yeah. So what is that, like six times it goes down? Not including all the way back at the beginning of my base. I start at the highest point. Base still over there. Is my base. Right underneath the chaos mount. Right next to the den. Right above Marilla's Hope. And then the unnamed city would be over that way. So I guess I could go down this way to the Red Dragon if I really wanted to kill the Red Dragon. Red Mama. Whatever you call her. Just wanted to show you guys the DLC armors and what they do. What can you expect from before making them? Is this what you guys know? You guys can gear up your thralls the right ways. So, hopefully you guys found it useful. Let me know. I'm gonna get back to this building build. It's just gonna take me forever. So I'll catch you in the next time. See ya.